998 into 567. I'll tell you, give it a try with a conventional way and try to see how it looks like in a Vedic way. So conventional way will really take you a three step solution to it with having a lot of addition and a multiplication. Let's check out how we do it in Vedic way. Here the numbers that we can think of is not near to 100, rather it is near to 1000. So in this case our base is 1000, that means 1 has 3 zeros. So let's find out how less is the number. It is 2 less. Better to write it as 002, so that we will always try to keep 3 numbers on the right side. And 567 is how much less than 1000 is 433 less than 1000. Now using our technique, we need to multiply the right hand side number, which gives us the number 6 and 8. And here either you do 567 minus 2 or you do not do 998 into 433, because anyway it's a very big numbers to be differentiated. Wherever you know the result will come same, so better to take the smaller numbers, 567 minus 2, which gives me 565. So the my answer is 565866. That's all is the answer. Just see how much time it is saving here. Let's take out another example to demonstrate this. We can take up 666 into 998. How less it is? 334. And this is 002. So once you multiply this, this comes to 4's 8, 2 3's 6, 2 3's 6, then 666 minus 002, which gives me 664. Let's take the calculator and check out both the sum. So first thing that I'm going to check is 998 into 567. 565866, absolutely correct. And the next one is 666 into 998. That gives me 664668. That's all. So here you can see how much time we are going to save by using these techniques. And I will tell you one more technique here. Sorry, not one more technique. I just want to extend it further to higher numbers. Okay. So let's check out a multiplication. I think whoever gets this kind of multiplication, they will be thinking that, okay, I must avoid this multiplication. I'm just going to give a multiplication. I suggest better you guys try once in a conventional way as we have learned till date, and then try out in Vedic way. So the number goes like this: 9 9 9 9 8 7 into 9 9 9 9 9 again and 1. Really big numbers, very big numbers. How much it is less than its contemporary number, which is near to 1 and some number of zeros. So we can write it as 1, 2, 3, 4, then 13. It is less than, this is how much it is less than the nearest number which has 1 and some 6 zeros. And this number is less by 9. So that we can write 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 and 9. So now 13 into 9 we need to do actually, which gives us 117, and remaining zeros we need to write, because as you remember I told whatever base you take, if base, how many ever zeros the base has, those many numbers we need to keep on the right side. So here if I take the nearest number, it will come 1 and 6 zeros. So base will be 1 and 6 zeros. So that means we always need to keep 6 numbers on the right side. That's what we have done. Now either you do 999987 minus 9, this minus, or this way minus. Whatever you do, you will get the result as 9999978. So our answer is 9999978000117. I can guarantee you this multiplication on a conventional way will drive you mad, completely mad, and it will take a long time, and I'm very sure if you don't do with very much of concentration, you will surely make it wrong. So let's find out using calculator, is it correct or not, because it's a bigger numbers. Let's find it out. So the numbers are 4987 into 591. Okay, this calculator has given up that I cannot calculate it. Let's check out in another calculator. The numbers are 4987 into 591. It gives me the answer, if you look at 4978000117. Our answer is absolutely correct. So this is the power of Vedic mathematics. So extend this formula to any higher numbers, you will get the result. So this is the higher number. We are just remaining with one more case. I will describe in the next lecture. So please understand this technique and practice the question set I have attached to this lecture. It will make you more refined in your techniques applying to the higher numbers. Thank you.